Our goal now is to model the space environment, much in the way that we model the weather, the troposphere, because we want to be able to predict space weather. We want to make predictions that companies that run technology could make decisions upon. It's the magnetometer chain on the 40-degree magnetic meridian. There's an existing chain in Greenland along the 40-degree magnetic meridian. That is where I did a lot of my early research. So we have recently made quite a large effort to put a set of stations that is magnetically conjugate to Greenland in the Antarctic. Magnetic field lines are connected to both hemispheres. And so it's important to look simultaneously in both hemispheres to really know what's going on. The challenge is that there are no little communities in the Antarctic where you can set up stations, and so there's no electricity, there's no hotel, there's no little cabin. And so we had to create stations that could work out in the middle of nowhere by themselves. It's very difficult to get there, so they have to work continuously for many years without being attended. We have just this year accomplished setting up six stations in the East Antarctic Plateau that are conjugate to the west coast of Greenland. And they're all performing now, sending back data, and we can look at both hemispheres simultaneously. We're looking at the interaction of the solar wind with the Earth's magnetic field, and that interaction produces electrical current systems. And those current systems flow in space and they connect to the ionosphere. And we've seen that now in both ionospheres, in the summer ionosphere and the winter ionosphere, it appears the currents that couple are constant. And that's a bit of a surprise, because in general, when you have a current, you think of a voltage relationship. And in fact, what we just observed is we don't have a voltage relationship. It's not a constant voltage that's applied to both ionospheres. It's a constant current. So that's a new part of the physics that we need to understand and work with. So the behavior of the sun and the material that's expelled from the sun changes over time. So the way the Earth's magnetic field responds changes in some ways. We're trying to understand that. Once you see this new thing, you could start to bring other observations to bear of what processes had to occur to make this happen. And that's kind of exciting. That's the fun thing. We're just really getting started.